I hope my lipstick's still on if I'm being filmed.
Yes, you're good.
Oh, thank you. Well, I'm Susan Lenart Kazmer. I am the creative director of Ice Resin here at Ranger. And this is Jen Cushman, who's gathering our stuff. She's actually the education director of Ice Resin. And I am the developer of Ice Resin. I formulated this this product in 2006. I'll talk just a little bit about my background as it relates to Ice Resin. So I went to art school. I studied a lot about talisman. I started working with sticks and, you know, just a lot of pieces like that as an artist. I worked commercially. I did a line of jewelry years ago for Bendel's and Barney's and Nordstrom. I had and museum stores. I did a line for it. I've done with Ice Resin. I've done museum exhibits at the Smithsonian and the Renwick. So for me, because I worked high end before, I moved into education. Now I love education. I love being around people. I love what I do. You know, I still do some of that now, but with Ice Resin, because I did big pieces, sterling silver pieces of jewelry, I have always had pieces that come back to me to be repaired. So I thought, you know, if I'm going to start using resin on my pieces, I better do something really cool that's going to last my lifetime. So I can be out of here when they need a repair, you know? I spend so much time repairing. So I really worked hard on I wanted crystal clear, I wanted a jeweler's grade, I wanted to be able to put anything into this work that I wanted to. In my head, I was envisioning this transparency with images underneath, you know, really popping. So with this product, you know, I've had like 10 years of developing ideas. With Ice Resin, you will never run out of ideas to present to your people who buy from you. You know, that's Jen.
Promise you, we will never run out of ideas for you to present to your people. So,
Jen actually has a design team. She runs a design team anywhere from jewelry to mixed media. Today, I'm talking a lot about jewelry, but this product, you know, really is components. I just call my components jewelry, but these can be really moved into the mixed media world. Yeah. And this actually is, so Jen, we have mixed media design team, we have jewelry design team, and this is the resin paper. You know, this is my journal work. I do lines of jewelry, but I also have done a line of mixed media. And this is actually the resin paper. I put some feathers on here with foils in the back. The resin paper on tissue or rice paper is absolutely super duper transparent. So, you know, this is just on a plain rice paper, or this might be a tissue. So I really like using these and layering. Here, this is the brown tissues. You know, for me, it's like I'm tearing it, but you can see right through the ends. Transparencies on the top. So that's kind of the rice paper, the paper this way. I brought the paper into, I brought it into a lot of different ways. Oh, here's the piece I'm looking for. This is on the bezels that I have here. This is a paper, so I'm just actually taking resin paper and creating hollow forms with this. So, you know, there's movement in there. I'm putting my glitters, because for me, my work originally that I was talking about that I did at the museum exhibits, I put talisman in there. So if I'm out at a beach and I love where I'm at and I want to remember, maybe I put my sand in here. Maybe I put a little bit of shells in here and then I'd cover it with resin. Maybe I put a photograph of who my body then I'm with, you know.
It's mixed media memory keeping,
right,
in a way.
Right,
it really is. But it's a way that it's much more subtle because it's so personal to you.
Yes, so it's really making personal pieces, and then I'd cover it with resin paper. I could stamp, I could write. I did a whole series with the resin paper where I just wrote all these notes and then ripped them and covered them. You know, so for me, they were my personal talisman that I carried with me. So that was, you know, some of the stuff we do there. This is actually kind of fun. I did this I taught a class Friday night. You know, I used these girls, I used their stamps. I love their stamps. You just stamp on, you heat set it, and you can pour ice resin over this. This is the feathers. I used my tints in the line with this. You know, so we did this in the classroom, and I wanted to see if everyone could build this. So they actually built this whole piece, leather and all, without tools. So I really came in with wire prepared. You know, I like using different ideas of how can you, if we had mixed media people coming in and working with jewelry now, what, and they don't want to go out and buy all these tools, what, how could we get started? So I was like, I want to really see if we can put this together without our tools. So we slipped wire through, we put things together, and we built this in our class. So it was pretty fun.
Do you need archival ink?
Yes. You do, yes.
Yep. Archival ink and you heat
for the stamps, yeah. So part of the line that I'm doing here, there's a couple of pieces I want to show you. So we came in, you know, with the resin, with the glitters and things like that. I am so excited about what we went on to with Ranger. It was the foils. When I saw the foils, I was like, we have to have these foils. You know, it really pops your, it's something I was thinking of for quite some time. So it really pops your resin work. You can do really flat work that work well on mixed media like this, you know, with the foils in the background. It brings anything out. What this resin does, if you put a piece of paper with words in, it magnifies and brings things out brighter. This is the casting and the tints. You know, this is my type of work. Here's the foils on here. This is casting and tints. This is just the type of stuff that I like to do with urban type of raw objects. So this is the ice resin. It's not glass. I like doing a lot of pieces that are lighter. I work with hardware. I work with things, crystals. And really when I cast them and use tints and bring it into resin, your piece is so much lighter. So that's a tint. Here's the foils. Here's the image pack. The image pack is made small, so it's all of my beautiful images, but they fit the bezels perfectly. So this really fits well. This is the foils in my line that I picked. Like, we're gonna need these colors here, you know? And the bezels, these are, I have a line of bezels that Justin and I and the team over here, we worked very hard putting together. One thing I do want to say, that if you guys are looking for exceptional metal in your lines, come to me, because I know metals. It's like out of anything. I did a commercial line for the craft industry in the jewelry department, and it was hugely successful because I know my metals. I hand make all of the originals, and then we have them made. We actually, once there's resin in here, it doesn't look any different than my sterling silver bezels and my bronze bezels. So really, there's no seams in here. There's no, it's a, really the perfect height for pouring resin into. So I was excited when we did it. I was like, oh my God, we did it, you know? So I was really excited about the bezels. So the line of bezels is on the front. If you guys, you know, are back in and looking around, there's a line of bezels that we're starting with. And the image packs that kind of fit right into here.
And for us in jewelry, a bezel is our canvas. So you have to have a substrate, correct? So we, when you're in mixed media, you have other substrates. This is our substrate that we work on and build from there.
And found, you know, for found objects or anything. Another part of the line that I actually developed a couple years ago, and my editor, she was like, I have the perfect name for you. You have to call it iced enamels. It's actually a cold enameling line. And I had a group for 5 days, and we did hot, the regular glass enameling, and we did iced enamels side by side. And really, you could not tell the difference at the end of this workshop. I love having people for long periods of time to educate that way. And this is, Jen has the piece on now. It's resin.
It's a lock, but it's all resin. So the entire piece, it's super light, it's easy to wear. And yeah, everybody looks at it and thinks I'm wearing a real lock.
Yeah, it looks like, yeah.
But that was my job, was to make it look like a real lock, but it's super light.
Yeah, so it's just, you know, and I teach a class called Resin Relics and Ancient Artifacts, where we're just getting in and we're kind of graffito and dirtying things up and hammering nails in and really making some really interesting pieces like that. So we're just taking, you know, we also found that people really are getting ready in resin to move on to their own pieces, casting. So these are just some cast pieces. You know, for us, you don't even have to worry about it. Be careful, they're gonna be opaque. And then this is the pewter iced enamel that we have on here. This is the whole row. I think we did these up so carefully that we, they're really hard to get up. But if you get a chance, that's all of our colors with the iced enamels. When you put ice resin over them, they look just like glass enamels. So, you know, it's just with a heater of like 300 degrees. It's waxes and resins and lighters. papers.
So for mixed media, the paper is huge to be able to do that, and then the castings. Those are great ways to use those on journals and everything, you know, to be able to do.
So to cast a piece like that, this is our putties. So this is this was an addition. I really, really love this mix. It really picks up very, very fine detail. I don't have my mold sticking. I don't have my resin sticking. I don't have any of this putty left, which I did have trouble with some of that in the past. So, it's nice. You can get about a good 3 pieces out of this, maybe 2 if you're doing something that big. And it's a non-toxic.
It's two-part silicone.
It dries like in 5-10 minutes, so this is a quick one. And you don't have to be exact with this where you do with the resin. So I'm just gonna take my 2 parts. What do I have to mold? I'll do the heart again. We'll do the heart again and move on. Okay, then I'll be able to put it. So I just wanna take this and I take it in my hands and I mix it up very, very quickly. Kind of knead this around. And when I'm in a workshop, I always tell people to be very attentive. When I'm in a workshop, I'll see people walking around and chit-chatting, and then they have like a hard ball in their hand. So I'm like, focus, move quickly, this has to be done. The longer, I want this super soft, and then I'm just gonna press my piece into here, and I always build it as high as I possibly can. I do because sometimes I wanna do a really tall pour, and sometimes I want shallow. I can use this mold over and over and over again, 20 times, 30 times. I can use these over. So with these molds, I want to show you guys one of the leaves. Oh, here. I'm going to show you guys one of the leaves. For me, this is a cast piece. I actually cast a leaf, and it has the foils in between, and I just darken the edges, and that's the resin paper on top. So with pieces like these and these, this has the resin paper. So I'm really kind of bringing jewelry and mixed media together and really, and this one again too, this piece I write my own personal notes on here, talisman on there. They're hidden away, but I bind it together as a talisman. I have my own words in here when I wear it. It's my stuff. So that's kind of what I really like to do with purpose. So I actually have this in here since I walked away. It's not quite ready yet, but I do have one, that I already did, that I can pop out. So now I'm ready to pour my resin into. I'll show you guys mixing in a minute. So this is just with, this one I didn't do too good. Not my best work up here when I'm demoing, but I think you guys get the good idea. This is dry. It's a 6-hour dry. All the bubbles work their way out. I can just leave it as it lays. It's done, and I can leave it as it lays, and then this one is ready to pop out. So that piece here, this is, I kind of wanted to show with mine, what I did is I actually, to give it really, because I was creating glass, I just did a coat of clear resin over it. You don't have to. I really try to make the education simple and have a nice piece, but you can really go beyond these steps to really create, something different than that too.
Do you put the clear resin over it after this is hardened while it's in the mold, or do you take it out?
Now, so I take it out and just paint it on.
Okay.
Yep. Okay, so then, so that's using the molds. The only thing I didn't show is mixing. Did I show you guys the druzy? Okay. So these actually, I think that was right where I was at when, did I talk about the druzy already? The druzy stones? Okay. It's hard when it's the last one. Sorry, you guys. I'm like, didn't I talk about this a lot? Okay. So the druzy, since I work with silver, the druzy is done with our glass. It's a glass glitter. I think because I am coming from this area, you're always going to find a really high quality here. And I'm really glad that Ranger supports that too. So we're really keeping this. So the glitter is really done and to a high quality. And when I am working with my, I'm working with my stones, and I was like, oh my gosh, my druzy stones look exactly like my glitter. I bet I can build a really cool piece, and have it look like a stone. So that's what I started doing with this. So this is actually, I'm going to show you how to build these. This is the leaf. You know, I want to take some found objects and show you guys too. Feathers that just have stamps on them. I heat set the ink, and I just use Ranger ink, stamping, heat set the ink, and then paint on. So resin can go over anything. Okay, so this is our plunger. I came out, I was an artist working in the mixed media and art world, and I have the one, you know, the two parts. People at first were so nervous thinking about mixing these exact. Once you get it, you can't lose. Once you get it, it's like riding a bike. There's no worries. So, but we did, because of that, we did come up with this plunger, and really the plunger is such a big seller. You know, I use the plungers in my workspace when I'm doing just a little bit of work. Like these druzies, if I'm like, oh, I have to just mix up one small piece.
Or covering your cast pieces.
Or covering my cast pieces, like I was talking about. I have these sitting around. The cap is beautiful. It just twists right off, and I can set the, you can't put it back on the wrong way. So this you just set down in here and twist. And I just set it up like this. It sits like this in my workspace. You know, once I can squeeze out what I need, mix it. These are the new cups with Ranger. I really like these because you can't slosh over the sides. The nice thing, when I did start working with these, we were so used to throwing our cups away that I was like, I can't throw this away. So these, alcohol takes resin off, not dry resin. But, you know, if you need to clean resin off your surfaces, alcohol, I'll take an alcohol wipe and wipe out, wipe my stick, and use it again. So, you know, really, whether, you know, that's going to be your choice. If it's going to say, throw it away. You know, I was like, damn, we're going to lose all those. Okay, so you want to start with resin. And I am going to mix exactly half and half. This one's almost to the end, so going to take a little bit longer.
You want to start with the resin. It's a little bit thicker than the hardener, so part A resin and then part B hardener.
Let me see if I have enough. You might have... I'll just mix up a smaller amount. I'm going to mix up a smaller amount this time. Usually I mix a little bit more, but my resin is low. Okay, so I can keep my resin, I can keep it like this for an hour, and then I can come up and mix it. So sometimes I do big batches, and then, you know, I come back in, and I encourage people to do their work, and then just leave your piece. It's a 6-hour dry. It can be heated to quicken it, but to me, it's like you can get beautiful domes with this work. You can, you know, to me, it's just leave it, and all the bubbles are gonna come out, everything's gonna be good. And then you just really wanna fold this. Wiping off the sides, coming back in. And, okay. I mix this for about a minute. You know, it takes me about a minute mixing it. And then I just usually will let it sit for about 5 minutes, you know, and go and finish up, do my things, put my work on. If I'm going to pour into a bezel, if I'm going to use my image packs or foil, I showed you guys how ice resin makes paper transparent. Well, if I don't want my paper transparent, which in a bezel, I really don't want my paper transparent, I am going to just kind of sink it into, I'm just ripping it, but you could cut it very carefully. This is just being ripped. Okay, so, you know, I'm gonna cut this to size. That lady has to go. And so what I really want to do is I want to seal it with my paper sealant here. It's water-based. It takes 5 to 10 minutes to dry again. And here's our paintbrush. There's paintbrushes with the line that are just, to me, I don't need, you know, we're not painting. We don't need really fancy, expensive paintbrushes for this line. So really, you know, there's a pack of six that we put the paintbrushes in. Once you put resin on your paintbrush, it's difficult to get off, you know. So we kind of want to use a little bit of the throwaway that aren't expensive and I'll use the other end of it to kind of tack our piece down. So this takes like five minutes to dry. You want to wait until it's dry before you pour your resin on here. So you can put your own images in there, you put transparencies, you can put, you know, anything you want to. So I'm going to wait for that to dry before I would pour my resin in. If I do, it'll be a little bit cloudy. Okay, so then the next step I want to show you guys, a druzy. If I'm going to make druzies, I've made a couple of them already. The way that I do these is I'm just going to put a little bit of resin in the bottom. You really don't want to fill it up that high at all. There's just a tiny bit in the bottom. And then I'm going to overfill my vessel with, is there a different? Yeah, there is a different color. Love this blue. Purple. Oh, yeah, that's the opals. There's a brown color and a chartreuse. Love these colors. So this, I'm just going to, and then the pink. Or like a rose. Love that color too. I think, you know, for a while I couldn't get enough of white and red and that pink. And now I think I went to France and it's so feminine there, you know, that I came back with, let's do everything pink and blue. So this is it. It's just an overfill like this. I'm gonna wait 6 hours for that to dry. And then, you know, what I do is I take a little bit of ink and my paintbrush and just dirty it up a little bit. Because if you look at real druzy, it's not perfect. It's just not perfect. So I dirty it up. So that's the druzy. And oh, okay, let me show you the resin paper. So these are the two. Oh, thank you, so nice to see you again. So this is the paper that I use for this. And so I'm gonna take this little piece here. Give me the spot. And I use the glove for this one because it can get messy. And I'll use something like a sponge, you know, just taking one up when it's moist. It's really easy, it's a throwaway. Doesn't give you inclusions in there. And I'm just gonna pour resin on here. This is the studio mats. I think that you guys are familiar with. They work perfect with the resin. So this resin paper, when it's dry, they will pull it right up off there. So you guys can continue to use these. I have them in my line too, the ice resin line. And if resin gets spilled on here, you can wipe it off with alcohol, or you can wait for it to dry and scrape it off with the credit cards. And that's it. So I would just do all my inking and stamping ahead of time and then coat it. So, you know, it just takes a little bit of time. I don't have to do the back. This one is completely saturated. I did that 20 minutes ago. And this one will get there. You know, it just takes a little bit more time. And I make sure it's dried flat. It'll all even out on the top.
Yeah. You can do all your stamping first. So you can do your stamping, your painting, your oil pastels, anything else you want to do with it. And you'll want to use the resin at the end. You can always go back after the resin's dried and you can use the paint mark, you know, the paint pens that Dilutions has and be able to paint over top of it.
Oh, here, you grab that off.
To do that.
Love.
So it's really amazing.
This is the opal. So we have opals. Besides the druzy, these are some of the really exciting stones. So when we're teaching stones, we make the druzy and we make the opals. And there's also a fire opal. Where's our fire opal? Is that the fire opal? Oh yeah, that is the fire opal. This is with paint in the background.
It's with tint.
I didn't make these boards. So sometimes you could paint the back of a bezel and put the opals in or mix them with our tints. And then you get these beautiful variation of stone.
That's totally making my heart go pitter patter.
Yeah, she was here like, what's that? Yeah. So if you get a chance also, you know, here's our glass glitters. There's our opals. Here's our iced enamel program right back here. And is there any questions? Is there anything that someone else wants to see? I know, it was really great.